Hi, this is Eddie from Switzerland with another knife review, and today we're going to take a look at a new knife from Concept Knives out of China. Concept is one of those higher-end overseas knife companies like Riad, Wee, or Kaiser, and they are a little bit a newer company. They're newer than, for example, Bestech, and they are comprised of some people that have worked with Kaiser knives, so they certainly know how to build a great knife, and they really cover a big variety in terms of price ranges and materials that they're working with. And I think they're doing a great job with collaborating with some different knife designers and having some variety in their lineup. And they also do locking, non-locking knives, slip joints, flippers, thumb studs. They really have a great variety, and I certainly would recommend to check out their newest catalog, where you can see all the knives that they have released for 2021. Today we're taking a look at a knife that is going to be particularly interesting to people that live in an area where they can't have locking knives, but they still want to have something fun, something fidgety. And that is also a trend that has been going on now for a short time. Like, for example, if the EWC from Ray Laconico, which is a front flipper with a double detent system that is fun to play with, non-locking and very legal in a lot of different places. And this thing is a little bit similar to that. So we're going to take a look at the Concept Fusa. So very cool name. I think it's a predatory animal that lives in Madagascar. And first off the bat, a thing that I have to mention, there is a very similar model in the Concept lineup that has a different name and some slight differences. That is called the Weasel. The Weasel has a little bit of different handle shape. I think it has almost the same clip, and it has a drop point blade shape. It is also a non-locking knife, as you can see right here. This is true for this one here, the Fusa, as well as the Weasel. So this video is probably applicable to most specifics of the Weasel as well. But I chose the Fusa because I really like this like toned down tanto blade shape. I think it really looks very good, also in combination with this nice neutral handle right there. Also the fact that it hides completely in the handle, the blade when it's closed, really makes it a sleek and very easy to carry folder. And on these knives from Concept, like with most of the knives that they have in their catalog, there are different options available in terms of handle scales. I think for the Fusa, there is a Jade G10 version, as well as a carbon fiber version. And here we have their green micarta, but you will see some pictures of the versions that are actually available. And then you have the Weasel option, which has a different, slightly different handle shape, a little bit more of a curve down here. And you have a drop point blade shape. The steel on both of these knives is going to be 154 cm, and the model number of this particular Fusa is T2020T2, so pretty easy to remember there. And the designer of this knife is actually Rolf Helbig, which is a German designer that actually has done some collaborations with Kaiser, for example, the Pinch, and some other Chinese manufacturers, and I think also and is also the designer of the Weasel. So certainly nice clean designs here by Mr. Rolf Helbig, but I haven't seen any kind of custom work by him so far, so maybe he's just a designer and not a knife maker. So before we go any further, I would just recommend to you to follow me on Instagram. You can find me on severity_knife_reviews and find some cool knife related content there as well. And also subscribe to me here on YouTube if you like the content so far, and put down a like as well as a comment if you have any kinds of questions or something you want to say. So let's take a look at the specs of the Concept Knives Fusa. We have an overall length here of 7.16 inches or 18.2 centimeters, with a blade length that comes in slightly above 3 inches at 3.06 inches or 7.65 centimeters, and a handle length of 4.1 inches or 10.8 centimeters. As I said before, the steel is 154 cm, so a well-rounded, at this point in time, budget-friendly steel. Good edge retention, good corrosion resistance, and adequate toughness was a steel that is, or is a steel that is still being used by Benchmade. Was their main workhorse steel that they used for a long time, and is certainly a great steel at the price point that this FUSA comes in at, and that is only $66.50. Of course, prices will vary a little bit depending on where you get your knives. I would recommend getting your knives at whitemountainknives.com. If you're from the US, you can find a link to that store in the description below, and you can use my discount code SEMREADY to get 10% off your entire order and make this knife even coming in at $60. So certainly a good price in my opinion from everything that you're getting here. Steel is good to go for sure. Different handle materials. I of course went for the micarta. It's a little bit a darker and more greenish micarta than you see, for example, on some other knives. I hope you can see the difference here. So it's very dark greenish and not as tanny as some other green micartas, like for example here on the Shirogorov or some aftermarket scales I got on the PM3. So certainly a more greenish micarta there, but it's nice and has a nice texture to it. It's not polished at all. Some stainless steel liners there. The backspacer is a little bit odd. I would love to see used some micarta right there, or titanium, or just something different than another green colored piece of G10. So that's a little bit of a miss there. The backspacer takes me a little bit by surprise. I thought it would probably be something else like titanium. Also judging from the nice 3D milled titanium clip that they have on this folder. Weight-wise, I have skipped over that one before. The Concept Knives FUSA comes in at only 85 grams, or just at 3 ounces. So very nice and easy to carry at an ounce, an inch mark there. So certainly nothing to be concerned about the weight of the Concept FUSA. So now let's do some size comparisons for the FUSA, so you can get a good feel for the actual size of this folder. First off, we have our Shiro comparison, F95NL at the top and Neon Zero at the bottom. And you can see it's smaller than both, but certainly closer to the Neon Zero. Then our benchmark EDC blades would be the Benchmade full size Bug Out and the PM3 you saw before. And you can see it nicely slots in between these two knives. Very similar in like overall shape to a Bug Out. A little bit shorter, you can see that here, but certainly easier to carry than a Para 3. Much, much more slender in terms of thickness. I think these will probably be very close. You can see that here, pretty, pretty close in overall thickness. Difference here, you can see the Para 3 has some nested liners here. They are regular liners with just a sandwich construction. But certainly thickness-wise, the same as a Para 3, and overall footprint-wise or length-wise, closer to a Bug Out, as you can see here. In terms of blade thickness, you can see it's going to be thicker than the Bug Out for sure, with a pretty standard overall blade thickness of 3 millimeters here on that 154cm blade. Then I have some other comparisons that are more in the smaller flipper area. We have, for example, the Riyadh Made original Micro Typhoon that is still in my collection. Then I have the EZE by Alliance Design, a nice Rayla Conico, also Tanto bladed flipper. And then I have the newest of these knives is the WeKnives Miscreant 3.0 by Mr. Brad Zinker. Great design and a custom knife maker that I really adore. And I think this one is probably the closest one in terms of overall size and feel in hand. Really great size for EDC in my opinion. You can see it's a little bit larger than the Micro Typhoon, and pretty close to the Miscreant 3.0, and in terms of length also pretty close to the EZE by Alliance Design and Riyadh. But a much less pronounced and aggressive Tanto blade. There is a very good comparison that I actually forgot before, and that is of course the Civivi Elementum. This one also sports some great micarta handles. This one has a D2 blade, and you can see size-wise these are very, very similar. And I think if you're interested in a Civivi Elementum, you probably are also interested in a concept Fusa. Of course, the Elementum is a liner lock, also has this kind of shadow boxed liner going on there instead of the standard sandwich construction. But you can see size wise, these are very, very similar right there. Also, blade stock thickness, tip strength. Of course, different kind of blade shapes. Of course, here we have a hollow grind instead of the full flat, but I think those two give you a great idea of each other's sizes. If you take a closer look at the overall construction here, we can see a nice, pretty well done and not overly decorated pivot screw right there, T8 Torx head, and then some large screws or screw heads here on the two body screws. In the back, we have the G10 backspacer we talked about before. And then here on this side, we have the 3D milled titanium pocket clip that actually works really well. Some good springiness, nice ramp, and it carries about like this. So a little bit of the knife is going to be protruding from the pocket, but certainly not a high carry at all. And for a 3D milled clip, that is pretty much a standard kind of carry that you would expect for a knife like this. In terms of blade, full flat ground Tanto blade with a pretty discreet secondary point down there, nice and symmetrical cutting edge, well executed sharpening choil, very interesting normal flipper that has this wheel look to it, like for example the Spyderco Ikuchi has, and it works really well. And of course, because it's a non-locking folder, you can have the fun you have with an EWC or any of these other double detent kind of flippers, and it certainly is great fun. Also, the knife is running on captured ceramic bearings, and they achieve all that fun action and fidgeting fun factor with just one detent somehow. So you see there, you have the detent, the non-skeletonized stainless steel liners, and it's the only thing that's executing the detent, as well as keeping the knife slightly open here. But you can see there is not a lot of pressure required to disengage that detent here. So this is certainly a knife that should be used as a slip joint only for light duty tasks, opening packages, letters and things like that. But you still get the fun and use of a great flipper knife, and it's really fun, and I wasn't able to get it to open and close in just one hard opening. So it's a very secure and well-tuned detent system here, and that is pretty impressive with a knife for only $66. So really well done, nice and smooth, pretty well centered right there, pretty much perfect. Also, the overall fit and finish of the liners, the scales and everything is really well done. Pretty toned down logo here from Concept. Good reflective stonewash finish that will hide wear quite well. And here you have the stop pin, nice flow through construction, only a small backspacer. I said before that I would like to see the material of that backspacer changed. Good jimping on that flipper tab, very easy to actuate. You can even do it with your thumb if you like that. And just a great option if you're looking for a fun and fidgetable but still non-locking folder. I would love to see a locking version of the Fusa or the Weasel or both in the future, because I think it's certainly a great overall design. I love these slender streamlined looks that have a very functional blade. Also, the tip here is very nice in a pretty a good medium between pointiness and strength right there. So really liking the overall design and the execution here on the Fusa, and I think for the prices that they charge here with this $66 price point, I think this is certainly something to consider, especially in areas where you can't have locking knives. For example, Germany, I think this will do very well as the Weasel, and maybe even in some parts of the UK. So great to see some larger companies paying attention to those knife nuts that can't have locking knives but still want a fun folder. And I think they did a great job here with the Concept Fusa. And I certainly think that this is the nicer or more exciting version of the two, the Weasel and the Fusa. I just really like that blade shape. And a thing that I'm always a big fan of is if there are different versions of the same knife available, which is the case right here. So if you want to get this knife, check out all the links in the description below. And if you like the video, please follow me on Instagram at 730_knife_reviews and follow me here on YouTube. So thanks a lot for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.